Hi, my name is Nick Martin. This is Toronto, Ontario, where I was born and raised. And this is me in front of the Calgary Tower in Calgary, Alberta. I first came to this province in 2005 to shoot a film called Search for Heartbreak. Since then, I've been back twice. Once to shoot a feature that I was fired from, and a second time to make this documentary. Ever since I first left the East Coast and came out West, I've had a strange feeling about small towns and small cities. I suppose it has something to do with being raised in the biggest city in Canada, but there must be something else to it. This fear has been symbolized in my psyche as a dragon for some reason. Smaller cities are filled with nicer people and less pollution, so why is it that I can't leave large cities without being haunted by the metropolis dragon? Is it being in a different time zone? Is it being isolated from the east? Is it simple homesickness? I will explore this psychological problem and more if you will join me in My History of Alberta. This is my home in Alberta, 69 Kentish Drive. And these are my Alberta parents, Rod and Marilyn Thomas. You've heard of the term Alberta hospitality, and they represent it tenfold. Rod manages the Calgary Petroleum Club, while Marilyn beats me soundly at tennis. And she's also a lovely hostess. But perhaps I'm getting ahead of myself. Stats about Alberta. Alberta was founded in 1905 and is named after Princess Louise Caroline Alberta, who was related to Queen Victoria, by the way. The current population of Alberta is 3,512,368, and the major exports are oil, beef, and cowboys. Three things I enjoy. I also enjoy the Bloody Caesar, which was invented in Calgary. Famous Albertans include Michael J. Fox, star of one of my favorite trilogies, the Back to the Future trilogy. And who can forget Bret the Hitman Hart? Alberta is also known for its winning hockey teams, particularly the Edmonton Oilers of the 1980s, and world figure skating champion Curt Browning. This is Hanna, Alberta, the home of rock and roll musicians Nickelback. This is Drumheller, definitely the smallest town I've spent time in Alberta. It is known for dinosaurs. Dinosaurs are the human beings of the Jurassic period. There are meat-eating dinosaurs, vegetarian dinosaurs, and homosexual dinosaurs. This is Ferdine, a gracious host in this small town. I once won a hamburger eating competition in her house. I've never been the same since.
First time I came here was when we were shooting Search for Heartbreak. I had one day off to come to this museum, and I was not allowed in because Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie, who were in town shooting the assassination of Jesse James, had the whole museum closed so they could go through it together without being bothered by their adoring public.
Upon climbing the world's largest dinosaur, I came to the realization that I was in the very mouth of the Metropolis Dragon. Drumheller was a constant reminder of the large lizard that manifested itself in my fears. I had to move on. This is Edmonton, the capital city of Alberta. And this is Colin Bradley, aka the Cobra. He's a resident of Edmonton and also my friend.
First thing that's wrong with Edmonton is like the people are really slow, but they're nice, but they're slow. Like, I don't know. They just don't catch on. They're not keeping up with the times. They're using, you know, systems and languages that have long since expired many other places. The other thing is Edmonton is too big and it's poorly planned.
Would you say that Edmonton is a big town or a small city?
It's a small city trapped in the body of a big town. And like, it's having an identity crisis right now. It needs some work. It needs to iron out a few of these wrinkles.
All right, Cobra, why don't you tell us a thing or two about this building behind us. What is this building?
This is the Ledge, the legislature. It's made out of some kind of fucking sandstone or something. I like to get drunk down here in the field with Ian and then just run by at night and be like, fuck you, it's still back!
The Cobra told me many interesting stories, including one in which a bear walked into a hospital in Calgary.
A security guard had to scare him out of the hospital.
What did he use, pots and pans?
I think, yeah, he just like yelled and was like, hey, get out of here! What would you do, man?
What would I do?
I'd hurl something at him.
I would run. There's a lot of fast food in Alberta, right?
Yeah, it's gross.
What's the best fast food in Alberta?
Wendy's.
Really?
Yeah, it's good stuff.
It's the best.
Yeah. I went to KFC the other day, horrible. It made me like crave Wendy's. I had these coupons. 2 crunch wraps. And by the time I ate the first one, the second one was cold.
Add to your meal.
They went Asian.
$6.
Oh yeah, what the Olympics.
Oh, that's just cheap.
Nick Martin. What is the one problem with Alberta that you would like to remedy or fix?
Oof. Well, I don't know whether there's a certain problem with Alberta. It's just, it's a real culture shock for me because I've always lived out east in very large cities and I come to Alberta and there's not, I mean, Calgary's pretty big, I guess, but it doesn't feel that big to me and it kind of confuses me.
I understand now. Now I get it.
True or false? You work for the government, Cobra.
I work for the federal government.
Whiskey bottles and brand new cars. Oak tree, you're in my way. There's too much coke.
I spent several days doing what the Cobra assured me were Albertan pastimes. Until one day I was watching the television and I saw something that changed me forever. There it was, the answer to Metropolis Dragon, the largest mall in North America, almost a large city in itself. If there was going to be one thing to cure my metropolitan malaise, surely this was it. It had to be. I decided to cool off by playing some Dance Dance Revolution in the West Edmonton Mall's Scotiabank Cinema. It seemed like something was drawing me there. Something I had little power over. Something that controlled me. There he was, in the flesh, the Metropolis Dragon. My greatest fears come to life. I thought I had escaped him, but he found me, in my one Alberta sanctuary. Then I realized, this wasn't the Metropolis Dragon, it was only a robot. The dragon lived inside me, and therefore I could control it. In the end, I realized that home is what you make of it. It doesn't matter if you're in the biggest city or the smallest village, just as long as you're surrounded by friends who care about you. That's all that matters. And as for that dragon, I hope that this simple thought will keep him at bay. Home is where the heart is. Well, I sure hope so.
Take me far away.